We're about to start track 13. There's only 14 songs on the record, so that means two songs from the con are left now. I know, Living Room wasn't on that record. But I admire the confidence that must come inside of a body that comes to the con X anniversary tour and yells out while they're playing the con for a song not on the record. That's off. That's right. We've been laughing a lot, actually, because throughout this tour we've been talking about the differences between Sara and I, and so when we finished learning the con, we collected some other songs to play, and I chose the most popular songs I've written because I want people to like me, and Sara chose, like, deep cuts, including a collaboration that just came out, so maybe a lot of people wouldn't know it, and I think that really defines us as people. And it's probably what makes us Tegan and Sara, which ultimately makes us likable, is that there's this balance between us, too much of one part of us. I mean, it's called the question over the years, like, maybe that we're incomplete without each other, because we need each other to be likable, but that's for another therapy session. But what's that now? Oh shit, sorry, I didn't hear because people were still laughing. Yin and yang, yes, yin and yang, sorry. It's one of those weird things you assume people know, but we have these things in our ears, they call them in-ears, and that's how the sound gets projected to us, so I can't, like, unless I take them out, I can't really hear you guys very well, but now I can hear it's completely silent, so that's clear as day. Little things about the show. Tonight I'm going to entitle my diary entry, Living Room. Rest assured, we play that song rare. So, yes. If you came here thinking, those bitches better not just be playing a con, they better play some other songs, including Living Room. But if you thought you were going to come here and get Walking with a Ghost, not happening. Closer? Definitely gonna happen. Monday? Nope. You play it to the rest of the songs you like. That's smart. You came here and you're here, Superstar. It's a trick. See? You need to get to know us. She's fucking with you. You know what, we actually learned, I always, when I ask this, I'm always surprised by how many people, and I'm not saying that you're gonna lie, but like, how many people here are familiar with Superstar? So after years of people shouting it, we had an actual tally that we used to do where we'd go backstage as a band and we'd be like, did anyone hear a calling for, like, did anyone call it for Superstar? You know, a guitar player would be like, I heard it. So we'd be like, okay, I got a request for Superstar. So for years, we got requests for this song that's bad, A. B, not really play, but we were like, every night, there'd be like one person in the audience that would just be like, Superstar! Like every song, and we'd be like, really? So finally, we learned Superstar. And the first night, we're like, you know, like, just like pumping up the audience, and we're like, are you ready? We're gonna do this like super obscure beat. Okay, are you ready? It's off the first record. We started playing it and it was like 1,000 people like this. And like one really excited person. And like we did it for a whole tour and some people knew the song, but like in general, we realized that that one person that just yells for Superstar is like the person who knows Superstar. Which is cool. Sara's gonna do our tour with Fit Ninja, where she's just gonna do obscure Tegan songs that she doesn't play. It's gonna be pretty cool, so you should get your tickets now, they're going pretty fast. Tickets are going fast. Alright, we got off topic. Two songs left on the con, we call this the optimistic part of the record. Here we go.